Firstly, a big thank you to all of you, because the channel has just passed the milestone of 10,000 subscribers. So to all of those of you who have subscribed, keep watching the videos and thank you very much. For those of you who haven't, do click the button to be notified when the latest ones come along. Now, a lot of the videos I've been doing recently have been using RESTful APIs built in ASP.NET. And I've been doing all of those using the more traditional approach, which is to use controllers. But something that's been around for a little while now is the idea of the minimal API. So I thought I'd do a couple of videos just looking at the differences between them, the pros and cons of both. And in this first one, I was just going to look at the basic idea of a minimal API, but also I was going to look at one of the big differences, or at least one of the big claimed differences, which is in performance. So let's take a look at what we're doing there. And so what we've got is this solution with quite a lot of projects in it, but the two key things, I've got this controller-based API and I've got the minimal API. So let's take a look at the controller-based one first. Should be very familiar because there's nothing new there. Obviously enough, we have the idea of a controller. So what I've got here is this weather forecast controller. We're injecting into the constructor a repository through that iWeather repository interface and storing it. And then all we've got is a very simple get endpoint, and we just get the forecast from that repository. The repository itself is in another project, which I've called Common. And so there we have got the interface, and then I've got a couple of implementations. I've got this local weather repository that just gives us back 5 random weather forecasts. So this is basically a slight rearrangement of the standard weather forecast that you get when you create an API using Visual Studio. So there's the one we've got there with those random ones. But then also I've got, implementing the same interface, an SQL weather repository that actually goes to a database I've created, which has 5 predetermined weather forecasts in there. So it's the same number of forecasts, but one of them is required to access the database. And then obviously I've got a DB context for that, and I've got a weather forecast model that stores that data. And so that's what's happening in the controller API. And then in the program, we obviously configure that for the local one to start with. We'll do the database one later. And then we've just got the add controllers and the map controllers. And that's what makes this work as a controller-based API. So if I set that as the startup project and run it up, I'm running it up, no debug, because we're going to be doing some benchmarking. And also you'll notice I haven't got Swagger or anything in there, so it's just run up the server, but nothing else. There's no messages showing there because I've turned off the logging so that we can get optimal performance when we do the benchmarking. So if we bring up a browser, drag that over, and then if we navigate to HTTPS localhost, and then this one is on port 7124, then we can see there we're getting back those random forecasts. Each time refresh, we get different values. That's what shows the random. So we've got that one server running. Now let's leave that up and running, but let's look at the other one we have, which is this minimal API version. And so we'll set that as the startup project. And then the thing to note is most obviously there's no controllers folder. There are no controllers in there. Really the only code we've got is program.cs itself. So if we take a look at that, we can see we still have to configure the repository, but we've got nothing about controllers. And in fact, all we have really is that one line that is our web service. So we're saying app.mapget. So you've got map put, map post, all of the different HTTP verbs, but map get, and then you have the path that's going to take us there. And then we pass as a parameter to this, we have the lambda, which is the function that we're going to execute when we get a request for a get for a weather forecast. So in the controller, the way that it decided what the URL was the name of the controller minus the word controller, and the way we knew it was a get because we put a get down here. So the same information's in there, but here we're doing map get, and then there we just hard code the path that's going to take us there. We pass in the lambda, and the lambda as a parameter in this case takes the injected repository. So it's injected into the constructor for the controller. It's injected directly into the lambda here. But then in the end, we just do the same thing, repository get forecasts, and it will give us the same behavior. And so if we run that one up, and again, we've just got the service running up, but if I go to the browser once again, and in this case, I'm gonna do localhost on 7032, which happened to know was the port we had to that one. And so there we've got the same data, but coming from the minimal API. So that's the basic difference between them, the lack of a controller. What that means is, in a simple case like what we have here, you're not worrying about the overhead of having a controller, both in terms of performance, but also in terms of just your program structure. So we don't need a separate controllers folder. We don't need to have controller classes. And when things are really simple, that makes a lot of sense. It's just overhead to put all of that in, particularly if you've only got one resource weather forecasts like we have here, even though you may have different operations like the put and the post, the delete, as well as the get. If you have more than one type of resource, which you would then have a controller for each one of those, then in a minimal API application, it would start getting a bit messy because you'd just have lots of these things listed in the program covering different resource types, all of the different operations, and it would just get longer and longer. So if you have a more complicated API, then controllers give you some structure, and that's going to be beneficial for organizing your program. Whereas the minimal API doesn't give you that structure, although you can add that structure for yourself without too much difficulty, and we'll look at that in later videos as well. But certainly for simple cases, it seems like an overhead to add the controller. The other issue people are going to be worried about, though, is what about performance? And so that's what we're going to look at here, because another project I've got in here is we've got this benchmarking project. And if we look at that, we are using the benchmark.net NuGet package, which I looked at in an earlier video if you want to look at the details of that. But all I've done is I've got this call get, and that will just make a get request to the URL that's been passed in, and then it will deconstruct the forecast simply as a JSON string and return that. And then you can see the two benchmarks I've got. There's one that calls it with 7032, so that's the minimal API, and there's the other one that calls it with 7124, which is the controller API, and that's what I've set as the baseline so we can work out off that. And then in the program, I'm simply running those. So let's set that as the startup project and then run it. And so remember, this takes quite a long time because it's going to run these tests thousands of times. So we'll skip through to the results come in. And there you can see the results, and you can see there is a difference. So using the controller, it was 115.8 microseconds per call, whereas using the minimal API, it was 105.7. And you can see the ratio of those of 1 to 0.91. So it's looking like about a 10%, maybe slightly less, benefit using the minimal API. And clearly that could be quite significant in terms of performance. So there is a definite performance benefit. You want to be a bit cautious about that, however, because bear in mind that the actual functionality of either of these is doing virtually nothing. It was just randomly generating those forecasts and returning them. So the overhead of the controller is really showing up here. That overhead is basically the fact you've got a controller class, each call, a controller object has to be created, and then it's going to be garbage collected. That's what's slowing things down. But to think about it in terms of a 10% improvement isn't really perhaps the best way to go. I would think it's more like a 10 microsecond improvement. So that's the difference between those two numbers there for the actual time it took to call. And I say that because even when things start getting complicated and these APIs start doing more things, they're going to take longer, but it's still only going to be a 10 microsecond difference, however long they take. So to show you what I mean, let's just get rid of that and go into these, and we'll kill the two existing APIs and then just reconfigure them so that we're going to have the SQL weather repository. So now we've actually got to get data from the database. So change that one, and put an SQL there. And then we'll run them both up again. So that one set as startup and run it in no debug. Set that one as startup, run it in no debug. And then go back and set the benchmarking as startup and then run that one. Once again, let's give that time to finish off. And there we can see the results. And this is what I mean. If you look at the ratio, it's now much, much less. It's now about a 3% benefit, still some benefit, but not the 9 or 10% that we saw earlier. And the reason is the actual difference between each one of them is still only about 10 microseconds, a little bit over, but the overall execution time is now three times as big because most of the work is now being done actually accessing the database, which is going to be the same for both of them. And that's the thing. Almost all the work that's going to be taking place once we're inside the method that's handling the request is going to be exactly the same. There's going to be no performance improvement. It's only the overhead of actually calling it, either pretty much directly through the minimal API or by creating a controller object when you're doing the controller-based API. That's where the difference is. And it becomes less and less significant the more that you're doing. That's not to say it's not worth it, but I'd always be aware that you want to do some benchmarking to see which is faster, and also that overall, it's the good structure of your application so that it's maintainable, readable by other developers, that sort of thing. That's what's most important. And we'll be looking in the next video or so at how we can do reasonably well-structured minimal API, web API applications. So, hope you enjoyed that one. If you did, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.